Hello everyone, welcome to my channel for Nursing Exams Learning. Today we will discuss one question about asthma and asthma exacerbation and its treatment. In the previous videos also we have studied asthma and its practice questions, so we'll discuss one more questions in this video. The nurse is providing discharge instructions on the proper use of prescribed short acting beta agonist and inhaled corticosteroid metered dose inhaler MDI to a client with newly diagnosed asthma. So here this newly diagnosed asthma, it's a keyword we should think. Which instruction should the nurse include? Select or that apply? I think for the past 1 week we haven't discussed any select or that apply question, is it? So this is, they ask which discharge instruction should the nurse give for a client who is prescribed albuterol as well as metered dose corticosteroid inhaler. So that is the question. So we have to think about the good points or some of the points that the nurse should teach. We'll see the options. Option 1, omit the beclomethasone if the albuterol is effective. Option 2, rinse your mouth well after using the beclomethasone inhaler and do not swallow the water. Then option 3, take the albuterol inhaler apart and wash it after every use. Then option 4, use the albuterol inhaler first if needed, then the beclomethasone inhaler. Option 5, use the beclomethasone inhaler first, then the albuterol if needed. So now we will see. Before we, in the previous question we have studied the albuterol short acting beta 2 agonist. Short acting, so that one usually used for a rescue medication, albuterol, and that is very short acting also. So here in the option 4 and 5 first we will discuss. Here the option 4, they said use the albuterol inhaler first if needed, then the beclomethasone. So what do you think? Does that a correct instruction should the nurse give? Because the client is prescribed with a both. So how he or she should take if they need? This is a correct statement. Whenever the client has prescribed with these two kind of group of medication, first should take the short acting albuterol agonist medication, which will help to improve the oxygenation or which will help to dilate the airway muscles, and that will increase the oxygenation by preventing the resistance. So then only we will take this corticosteroid metered dose inhaler or beclomethasone inhaler, that is a corticosteroid. Otherwise if you will direct, first you will take beclomethasone, then we are taking albuterol. See, in this asthma condition we said that it is already constricted and there is not enough oxygen and the client is suffering to get the oxygenation because of the constricted bronchial tubes. So if we are directly starting the beclomethasone and still the bronchial tube is constricted and it is inflamed, there is no way to move the air and the resistance is more, the beclomethasone will not give the good therapeutic effect. So first we will give albuterol, that will make the way clear. Then we are giving the beclomethasone as a second one. So that will give a good therapeutic high effect. So this is a correct statement. I hope it's clear. Beclomethasone, it is a, this metered dose inhaler, it is a long-term medication that is usually using for controlling the inflammation, asthmatic inflammation. So our option 4 is a correct option that we can use. Then here option 5 said use the beclomethasone inhaler first, then the albuterol if needed. No, we said first albuterol, then the beclomethasone. So here we can eliminate option 5. That's why I told, whenever you will see such kind of options difficult, try to eliminate the one you have, you are clear. Then we'll go with some of the difficult options. Then now we will see. So now we will eliminate option 5 and we got one correct answer, that is option 4. Now we have 3 more options. Out of 3, which all are the correct, we will see. See, here they said the option 3, take the albuterol inhaler apart and wash it after every use. Actually, it's not like this. Because if we are taking albuterol, no need to wash after every use. It can be do like 2 or 3 times a week, 1 or 2 times a week. That is the recommended instruction for using the client who are taking albuterol inhaler. See, here you can see the albuterol inhaler apart, washing the mouthpiece, not the canister, okay, clear that one. Washing the mouthpiece under the warm running water and letting it dry at least 1-2 times a week is recommended. Medication particles can deposit in the mouthpiece and prevent a full dose of medication from being dispensed. If we will not wash 1 or 2 times in a week, what will happen? It will block the way and the full dose of medication will not be dispensed. So that's why we should at least wash it with warm running water 1 or 2 times a week. Then what was the another point that we said? Rinse your mouth well after using the beclomethasone inhaler and do not swallow the water. That is a correct statement. Why? Because we know that the client, those who are taking such kind of medications, inhaler, there is a chance of depositing some minute particles in the mouth. So what will happen? This particle will stay and that may develop candida. It's like a thrush, white spot on the tongue, buccal mucosa and throat. That is a common side effect of inhaled corticosteroids. So the nurse should instruct the client, whenever you are taking these medications, this metered dose inhaler corticosteroids, you should rinse the mouth and throat well after using the MBD and not swallow that water. That is the recommended, not swallow that water. That water should spit out to help prevent the candida infection. And that is one of the common side effect of inhaled corticosteroids. So that option is also a correct statement. Option 2 also a correct statement, because the nurse should instruct the client, you should rinse the mouth after the use. So now we have got 2 correct answers, option 2 and option 5. Now the another option, the pending option, that option 1, omit the beclomethasone if albuterol is effective. We said what purpose we are using beclomethasone. That is a long acting medication that is using for the controlling the airway inflammation. But this albuterol is different, it's entirely different. That is a short acting rescue medication. So we could not stop or taking the beclomethasone or the long acting medication once albuterol is effective. We should take, if the doctor has prescribed that one, the client should take that one, because that is for long term purpose and that is necessary, essential to decrease the airway inflammation or controlling the airway inflammation. So here what they said, no need to use. If one is effective, another one is no need. No, that is not the correct answer. So our answers are option 2 and option 4. I hope it's clear to you. This is one of the good select all the reply question that I have come across, especially related to asthmatic topic. So please review the topic as well as review the questions. So if you would like to discuss more questions about asthma, please mention in the comment box and we'll try to add more questions and we'll try to explain more. So bye for now, study well, and I wish all the best for all your exams and studies. Bye bye.